I'm Keija Minor, editor-in-chief of Brides at Condé Nast, and this is how I made it. I was working as a corporate lawyer. By year two, realized I didn't want to do that anymore. Spent another year, I'd say, really identifying what I wanted to do, which was work in magazine publishing. And then I took classes and started to network and also saved money and decided that I would save a year's worth of mortgage payments and then I would quit regardless. And that date was getting closer and closer, and I didn't have a job or didn't have a job in publishing. So I flooded the industry with my resume. I literally applied to, I think, probably everyone besides like Guns and Ammo and like Popular Science. No one would hire me. And then finally a travel magazine called Travel Savvy, which was just starting up at the time. They hired me as an intern in the lifestyle department. So I quit my job, took an 85% pay cut to work there in the lifestyle department. Absolutely loved it. I think I started on a Tuesday and they said to me, we need you to go to London on Friday to try out the new flatbeds on Virgin. And I thought, huh, my last business trip, I was reviewing documents in a warehouse that didn't have any windows for about 12 hours. This business trip, I'm going to London to try the new flatbeds in upper class, staying at the Sanderson, going to a party that Branson was having, and then flying back. And I thought, yeah, I could get used to this. I may be broke, but I'm very happy. Worked there for about 2 years, worked my way up to editor-in-chief there, and then left to go to Niche Media to be managing editor of LA Confidential and Aspen Peak, but doing it from New York, and then became editor-in-chief of their flagship publication, Gotham. And people always say to me like, oh, was it huge moving from LA to Gotham? I was like, no, I was always in New York. I basically just changed my voicemail and went back to work. And was editor-in-chief of Gotham, loved it. And then got the call from a good friend of mine, Len Burnett, who was the publisher and founder of Uptown. And Uptown, at that point, they had been around for a few years, but they had just received major financing and were really expanding the publication. And it was an opportunity to help build something, a magazine that really defied stereotypes, that was for professional black folks, that there weren't really any magazines that were really serving that audience well at that time. And the idea of building something with a great team was really enticing. And so I left Gotham, a job that I loved, to go to Uptown, where I was editor-in-chief for a couple of years. And then I moved to Condé Nast as executive editor of Brides, and then was promoted to editor-in-chief. And so here I am. The most rewarding part of my job, I'd have to say, is probably when we hear back from our audience that we help them in some way plan their wedding or relax during the planning or enjoy their wedding. In any way that we can help our audience, like that's what we're focused on every single day. So when we hear back from them, usually through social, that we helped in some way, that's definitely the most rewarding part. At Brides, I'm helping women plan the biggest party and event of their life. There are very few moments when you realize like, okay, I am closing one chapter and starting another. Usually it's like you can look back and see it, but there are very few times when you know what's happening. So to have an audience that's so engaged and going through such an exciting time, I can't imagine what would top that. And in terms of what's next for Brides, we're always working on the next big thing. But as weddings evolve, as marriage evolves, as technology evolves, all of these things affect where we go with Brides. And we also have a lot of licensing deals in the works. We put on what's called Brides Live Wedding. It's a huge national contest where we throw a wedding for one very lucky and deserving couple, and then America chooses the couple, and then every aspect of the wedding, from her dress to the flowers. And I can see us expanding that to make that into, you know, every year it gets bigger and better. We've got a lot of things in the works, so yes. Exciting things to come. Stay tuned. I was like, we're only 80 years old. And we're in our best years now, I'd say.